Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to welcome every one of you, first timers, prayer line, Facebook, and everyone. Welcome once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Canada. Welcome once again. I'm going to talk to you the subject called, Oh God of Miracle, Answer by Fire. Oh God of Miracle, Answer by Fire. Our God is a God of miracle. Our God answer by fire. God work mysterious miracle. Mysterious miracle. God is a God of miracle. Yes, that's why we are going to talk to a God of a miracle. Before the end of this year, before the end of this month, your miracle must appear. Your miracle must appear. Your miracle must come. If you are looking for something, you have been praying here, you have been trusting God for something, it is your miracle time. It is your miracle time. Your miracle is coming in the mighty name of Jesus. Then people will know that there is God in heaven. People will know. Your family and everybody who is around you, they will see the miracle and they will know that there is God in heaven, that you are a true child of God in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that let your miracle appear. Let a miracle appear by fire. Let the miracle appear by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything holding your miracle shall die, shall be destroyed, shall be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that your miracle, receive your miracle right now. Receive the miracle that will disgrace the enemy, that will disgrace every work of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. God of impossibility will appear and perform a miracle in Jesus' name. Let's look in the scripture from the book of 1 Kings 18, verse 30 to 39. 1 Kings 18, verse 30 to 39. Sister Agnes, go ahead and read for us, please.
Okay. Then Elijah said to all the people, come near to me. So all the people came near to him. And he repaired an altar of the Lord that was broken down. And Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes, the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord had come, saying, Israel shall be your name. Then with the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord, and he made a trench around the altar large enough to hold 2 shields of seed. And he put the wood in order, cut the bull in pieces, and laid it on the wood, and said, fill 4 water pots with water, and pour it on the burnt sacrifice and on the wood. Then he said, do it a second time. And they did it a second time. And he said, do it a third time. And they did it a third time. So the water ran all around the altar, and he also filled the trench with water. And it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your word. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that you are the Lord God, and that you have turned their hearts back to you again. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stones and the dust, and it licked up the water that was in the trench. Now, when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces, and they said, the Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God.
Amen. God bless His word. You know, there's something here. I read that the whole story so that you can understand. that God of miracle is God of a miracle up to today. God of a miracle is not the God of a miracle only during the time of Elijah. God of a miracle is still God of a miracle up to today. Let's look at this scripture. As you have heard the miracle of that God who answered by fire. And the Bible says, then Elijah said to all the people, come near to me. So all the people came near to him, and he repaired the altar of God, which has been torn down in the mighty name of Jesus. There is an altar that has been destroyed, that has been torn down. There is a satanic altar that has been destroyed. There's a satanic altar that needs to be torn down in the name of Jesus. Yes, yes, Lord. My God, I want to thank you. So the altar of God was destroyed. And then the altar of God of God was torn down. So Elijah said, I want to repair that altar. 1 Kings 18:30. Now the Bible says, then Elijah said to all the people, come near to me. So all the people came near to him, and he repaired the altar of the Lord which had been torn down. So the altar of the Lord was destroyed. The altar of the Lord was torn down. The altar of God, was broken down. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that the repairer, the Lord Almighty, will repair your altar. Anywhere, any altar that has been destroyed, the altar that has been destroyed, the God of Elijah, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will repair your altar in Jesus' name. Some of you, your altar is torn. Some of you, your altar has been broken. So you don't have the altar of God. You have the altar of the devil. You have the altar of Satan. You have the altar of witchcraft. The witchcraft will build altar in you, in your life. So we will repair the altar of God. We'll bring the altar of God in Jesus' name. There is an altar that will bring miracles. Without repair the altar that bring miracle, there will be no miracle. You must repair your altar. You must repair the altar of prayer. You must repair the altar of deliverance. You must repair the altar of prosperity in the mighty name of Jesus. That is the altar that has been broken, that has been torn. So Elijah called people and repaired the altar first before he could call fire. So let your altar be repaired in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree by the decree of God, any altar that has been torn down, any altar that has been destroyed, let it be repaired in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, my Father, I want to thank you. The Bible is good. Hallelujah. Verse 31. Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord had come, saying, Israel shall be your name. So with the stone he built an altar in the name of God, and he made a trench around the altar, right enough to hold 2 measures of seed. The altar, hallelujah. You will be built an altar of God in the mighty name of Jesus. The altar, that the altar of prosperity, the altar of healing, the altar of prayer, the altar of miracles, you will build the altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, your altar is very important. Without an altar, there is nothing can happen. You know, after the altar was rebuilt, Elijah built the altar of God. Now, after the altar of God, and then the Bible says, and then he arranged the wood and cut the ox in pieces and laid on it, on the wood. And he said, fill 4 packets with water and pour it on the burning offering and on the wood. He said, oh yes, you know, the altar needs a sacrifice. The altar needs a sacrifice. That's why I always tell people, as your altar been built, do your altar, as your altar has been built, do you have an altar? We need to raise an altar for you. We will destroy the altar of Satan. We'll build an altar for you. So when I look at people, I see they have an altar of sickness. They have an altar of poverty. They have an altar of sickness and diseases. So those altars, we need to destroy them. We need to repair the altars and build an altar of health and build an altar of prosperity and build an altar of prosperity that will prosper you in Jesus' name. And every altar, you must give a sacrifice. You must offer the altar. That's what happened. The man of God, Elijah, he offered the altar, because the altar, you can't do altar without offering. You will be killed. The demon will kill you. Witchcraft will kill you. Because they spend a lot of money to build the altar. Now you want to build the altar empty. It, you can't build. It cannot work. So you have to go with the altar. You have to give a sacrificial offering for building an altar. Now, when if you know you are old, you don't have an altar, call me. If you need me to build for you an altar, to raise up an altar for you, call me. My number is 905-792-3798. Before the end of this year, you have to build an altar. And you know your problem. You know what you are facing. You have to raise up an altar. Because this altar, it will answer you by fire. When you go to the altar, the elders, even this man, the man of God, the prophet, he had an altar. That's why the altar was answered by fire. It is a miracle. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Then the water, verse 35, the Bible says, hallelujah. The Bible says, my God, thank you. The water flowed around the altar, and he also filled the trench with water. At the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, at the time of offering evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet came near and said, "Oh Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, today let it be known that you are a God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and I have done all these things at your word." So when you raise an altar, when you have an altar, you have permission, you have power and authority to go to your altar and cry to that altar. Like this man, Elijah the prophet, as he raised up and cried, when there is a situation, when you are facing with a situation, that is when you have power and authority to go to an altar. When you raise up an altar, the altar that you have built, you will cry there, and God will answer you by fire. My number, call me if you need me to raise up your altar before the end of this year. You need an altar. Call me. The number is 905-792-3798. I will raise up an altar of salvation. You need your people to be saved. You need your husband, your family to be saved. You have to raise an altar of salvation. That altar, when you go to declare, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel will answer you by fire. Now look at 37. The Bible says, "Answer me, O Lord, answer me, that these people may know that you, O Lord, you are God, and that you have turned their heart back again." So God answer you. God will answer you by fire, so that people will see there is God in heaven. Let me tell you something. When I was a minister, I was a pastor, I had a church. None of my children were saved. All my children were in the world. No one was saved. My husband was not a Christian, and I was a minister. Disgrace. The time I learned how to raise an altar, the very children who were wandering all over the world, they became Christian. My son, who was a criminal, a leader of criminals, is now a deliverance pastor and a prophet of God. Pastor William Isigi. Sometimes you see him coming. He's a pastor. He's a ministering in a pastor. He's a pastor. Let me tell you, when you know how to raise up an altar, your whole family will be saved, according to what Moses said. Me and my family will serve God. It is true. It is very sad when you are a Christian. Your children are wondering. They don't want your God. But when you raise an altar, when you go to that altar, God will answer you by fire. God of a miracle is a miracle. It's not magic. It is a miracle that will answer. You will be surprised. Of all the people, I went to the altar. I cried to the altar. I raised up the altar. I give sacrifice. I give offering to that altar. I did everything. My God answered me by fire, by bringing my son back, bringing my children back, bringing everything that was lost back in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 8, the Bible says, then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burning offering and the wood and the stone and the dust and licked up the water that was, which was in the trench, the trench. Now the fire of God fell from heaven and consumed the offering. Now, you see, this is still the same. That's why when you give your tithe and offering, I raise up to the heaven. I pray that God let your heaven open and receive this offering. You have to pray until you see heaven open and receive the offering. When heaven receives offering, no powers of darkness will hold your blessings. No powers of darkness will hold your miracle. Because heaven has answered you by fire. The fire will come and consume your offering. That is how it is. When you know how to build your altar and you give that offering, you see, it was consumed. The fire opened from heaven and it was consumed. And those people were shocked when they saw the fire, and the fire came and consumed. It is the same thing. Fire always come and consume your offering. That's why you get miracles and signs and wonders. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Then the Lord, and then hallelujah, verse 39, when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, the Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God. People around you, people will come to you and ask you, where is your God? God is surely there is God. God is God. A miracle that will make even demon will confess that God is really God. When they know that you are nothing will happen to you. Now they see you, God is really a God. God of a miracle. God who answer you by fire is a God of miracle. Not only God of Elijah, is the same God. Jesus Christ is the same today and forever. God is the same today and forever. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you. We thank you. Call me. If you need us if you need me to build you an altar, to raise up an altar for you, our number is 647-608-5207. Treasure, light them for people to see it. 647-608-5207. Call me. I will raise up an altar before the end of this year. You need an altar. You need an altar which answer by fire. And then the whole world, the people will know, surely there is God in heaven. He is a God. As the way they answered, he is a God. Our number, we have two different number, three numbers. We have three numbers. If this one is not working, you can always call this number, 905-792-3798. God will answer you by fire in Jesus' name. Let's look another scripture from the book of John 14, verse 13 to 14. Hallelujah. Agnes, go ahead.
Okay. John 14, 13 to 14. Okay.
Yes.
John 14, 13 to 14.
Yes.
Okay. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it.
Amen. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. My name, in my name, I will do it. Ask anything. Ask a miracle. Ask a miracle. Ask what you want. Jesus will do it in his name. ask a miracle. He's God of a miracle. He has given us his name. Ask him anything you want, he will do it for you. When you have built an altar, when you have built an altar, then you can ask anything. In the name of Jesus, he will do it for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, what are you looking for? What do you want? What are you looking for? What miracle do you want God to give to you today? In the mighty name of Jesus. God of impossibility is God is here. He asked and he said, ask me anything in my name, I will do it. Yes, God is a miracle God. God is a miracle. If you are traveling at your workplace, if there is enemy that is troubling you, if you are having troubles at the workplace, if you are looking for a job, call me. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We are the one to speak to those enemies that is attacking you. They will be disgraced. We'll speak the word of God, and the fire of God will go to that place and confuse those people, and they will bow down to your God, and they will God will answer by fire, will answer you in Jesus' name. Yes, the case, people with the cases, if you have a case in the court, call me. Call me, because God has forgiven you and no one will hold you in bondage. Call me. God will help you. God will deliver you in Jesus' name. Call me. My number is 905-792-3798. Call me. I will deal with them. God has given me favor and has given me gift to deal with the satanic people, to deal with the wicked people. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, the children of wicked will not waste you. The children of the wicked will not waste you. Yes, call me. It will be dropped. It will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Call me. If you have any case in court, a court of Elijah who answer by fire will destroy it and drop it in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Because the Bible says, ask anything in my name, I will do it. Ask God to drop that case. Ask God to give you a job. Ask God to confuse those people who are working against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Now, let's look in the book of Daniel 2, verse 28 to 30. Daniel 2, verse 28 to 30. Hallelujah. Praised be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes.
Daniel 2:28-30.
Yes.
But there is a God in heaven who reveals secrets, and he has made known to King Nebuchadnezzar what will be in the latter days. Your dream and visions of your head upon your bed were these. I pray you, O King, thoughts came to your mind while on your bed about what would come to pass after this. And he who reveals secrets has made known to you what will be. But as for me, this secret has not been revealed to me, because I have more wisdom than anyone living. But for our sake, who made known the interpretation to the king, and that you may know the thought of your heart.
Amen. Amen. God answer. May God bless his word. You know, here is the degree the king has issued. King has said everybody will die. If nobody will reveal this secret, this dream about what I dreamed, they will die. He called his wise people. He called his wise men. He called witchcraft. He called star leaders. He called everybody. There was nobody who can answer the dream that the king had. But there was a man called Daniel. When Daniel heard that the king had said everybody would die because nobody is interpreting the dream, Daniel told him, my God who answer by fire will answer me by fire. He said, I will interpret that dream. Daniel was not a special child. He was ordinary like us. But he went to the altar. He went to his altar and they called God who answered by fire. Oh, God of a miracle. God of a miracle answered Daniel by fire. Now, the Bible says Daniel 2 verse 28 to 30, the Bible says, verse 28, but there is a God in heaven who reveals secret, and he has made known to the king, King Nebuchadnezzar, what will be in the late days. Now Daniel told the king, King, hear the word of God. There is God in heaven who reveals things. Our God answer by fire. Our God, he reveals things, secret things you may not know. God revealed it very clearly. God revealed the secret, what will happen to the king and what is going to happen late days. This is the God that we serve. That is the God of a miracle. God can never do anything without revealing the secret to his servants. Now God went and revealed the secret to the wicked king, a king who does not is not he was a pagan king. He was not a godly king. Now when he got the dream, the king said, "No, I have to find out what's wrong with this dream." And Daniel told him the dream that God has said about the dream. Look at this. Now Daniel is explaining the dream the king had. You know, this king has not mentioned the dream to anybody. But God, who answered by fire, revealed the secret, the dream to Daniel. The same God, who is the same God of Daniel, is the same God that we serve. He will reveal the secret of your dreams. He will show you the dreams that you had, and the meaning of the dream. Because God, who answered by fire, is a God of miracle up to today in the name of Jesus. Now, this is what Daniel said. Your dream and the visions of your head upon your bed were this. As for you, O king, thoughts came to your mind while on your bed about what will come to pass after this. And who reveals secret has made known to you what will be. He who reveals the secret, he who, look at that, it's capital letter, he is God. He who reveals secrets has made known to you. Daniel told the king, he who, our God has made him. God speak to the wicked, to the evil king. God spoke, God from heaven speak, gave a king a dream. That's Daniel saying, he who reveals secret has made to know what will be. Yes. But as for me, this secret has not been revealed to me because I have more wisdom than anyone living. But for our sake, who made known the interpretation of the king, and that you may know the thoughts of your heart. David declared to the king, he said, King, it's not because I'm special than any other living people, or than other, you are wise prophets, you are wise witchcraft, you are wise star readers. I'm not better than them, but because the God who answered by fire, because the God whom I serve is God, is a God who has revealed it. The Bible says that you may know, and you may know that this very God is God who has revealed to you. So we have a God who reveals secret, a God of miracle, a God who answers by fire. He will never do anything without revealing a secret to you, because he's a God of miracle. And your dream can be a miracle. Your dream can destroy you. So it's better you understand the dreams. It's better you get interpretation of the dreams. It's better when you wake up, you destroy every satanic dream, every witchcraft dreams, every dreams that is not from God. Let it be destroyed. If it is from God, ask God, please, Father, favor me. You know, you go pray and fasting, a serious warning like this one. Now, when the king was given an interpretation and the meaning of the dream, he didn't do anything. He did not do anything. He just say, okay, it's just a dream. And for sure, the dream came to pass. This man went and became animal and started eating grass. Before you eat the grass, the Lord will reveal to you the secret. Before you get troubles, before you get accident, before you go to poverty, the Lord always will reveal secret. Many of you, many things happening to you. It is because you didn't know. You had a dream, but you didn't know what to do about it. But God of miracles, God who answers by fire, will destroy every dreams that you have that is waiting to manifest. The God of Elijah, the God of miracle, the Lord who answers by fire, will destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy every dream that is waiting to manifest in your life, the life of your children. I destroy them. I bind them. I command them to catch fire. I render them fireless. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. By the power that created heaven and earth, let those dreams die. Let them be wasted. Let them be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Yes, my God, I want to thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We are going to look at the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel 2, verse 6 to 8. 1 Samuel 2, verse 6 to 8. Hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus. Give me hearts. I know you are listening or you are writing. I need to have more hearts. It is the heart of God. Let's look in the book of 1 Samuel 2, 6 and 8. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Every satanic dream, I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, you go ahead and give me more hearts. Punch those hearts as much as you can. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. 1 Samuel 2, 6 to 8. Agnes, go ahead, please.
Okay. The Lord kills and makes alive. He brings down to the grave and brings up. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He brings low and lifts up. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the beggar from the ash heap to set them among princes and make them inherit the throne of glory.
Amen.
For the pillars of the earth.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Okay, yeah, that's
amen. Sorry. Lord, bless your word in Jesus' name. Listen, people of God. The same God, Jehovah, is the God who kills and makes life. God kills and makes life. Anything that must die for you to get your breakthrough, let them die. Anything that wants to die for you to get your miracle, let them die in the mighty name of Jesus. God kills and God makes life. Any power, anything that is holding your miracles, let them die in the name of Jesus. Let God kill them. Any power that is holding your miracle for years and years, let them die. Let the fire of God consume them in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything that has died in your life, let it become alive in Jesus' name. I'm calling life. Anything that is dead in you, let it come alive in Jesus' name. Because God kills and God makes life in the mighty name of Jesus. He brings down to the grave and brings up. God will bring some people to the grave. God will throw people to the grave because it's God. This man, Nebuchadnezzar, he was so exalted. He didn't know God. He didn't recognize God. God made him to go to eat the grass like animal. So God will bring some enemies down and lift up you. God will kill a person. God will kill the powers that is all in you so that you can go up. You see, in the book of Isaiah 6, God has to kill that king. And then Isaiah saw God. The Bible says, when King Isaiah died, Isaiah saw God. So any power that has been holding you shall die. Then your miracle will come in Jesus' name. King Isaiah died, and then Isaiah saw God. And after the death of King Isaiah is when Isaiah saw God. Any power that is holding your miracle shall die in Jesus' name. Let those power die. Let God kill them in Jesus' name. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. The Lord will make you rich because it is power to make you wealthy in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, you know, there was a rich man, very rich. He was so proud of the riches. Then he was saying that I'm going to eat my wealth and what. And God said, today you are going to die. You will go. And your wealth will be coming zero. And God raised up the one who's calling upon him. And God will give you power to become wealthy in Jesus' name. The love of money is the source of all evil. If you worship money, you kill people, you do evil for money, it will not work for you. God is the one who makes you rich. You don't have to worry. Once you are built an altar, the altar will bring you wealth and you will be super rich in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. He brings low and lift up. Up and lift up. Lord hates the proud. God hates the proud. God will bring the proud down and lift you and lift the humble up. Now, when God was dealing with Saul, God told Saul, go and kill everybody. Don't spare anybody. When Saul went and looked the fat women and the animals and all the wealth of those people, Saul says, I will keep them. That was not the plan of God. Because of that, God became very angry with Saul, and he has to destroy Saul. Saul died because of rebellious. He will bring you down, and he will raise up another. And God brought Saul down and raised up David. David was raised up. And remember how Saul was chasing David to kill him. But because of his heart, because of greed, because of evil, he brought him down and raises up David. So that is how this one to work. That boss, that manager, who is bothering you, who is worrying you, who is fighting you, the Lord is going to bring him down and he will raise you up. That bank manager, that evil manager, that satanic manager, that satanic supervisor, that satanic director manager, that satanic president you have, the Lord will bring them down and they will raise up another to take over in Jesus' name. Don't worry, you raise up the altar. You will go to the altar of God and God will speak from the altar and he will bring that person down and they will raise up another one. It is Jehovah. It's the power of God. That's God how it works in Jesus' name. Yes, hallelujah. That abused wife, that abused woman, that abused husband, God will bring her down and God will bring and raise another in the mighty name of Jesus. Jezebel was killed by this man called Jehu. Jehu killed a woman. He went there and threw her from the window and died. Because Jezebel was a wicked and evil woman, God brought her down and raises another in the mighty name of Jesus. King Ahab, God killed him and raised up another. So anywhere, any leader who is threatening you, who is frustrating you, God will destroy them. Remember, God is a killing machine. I will kill and lift up another in the mighty name of Jesus. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the beggar from the ash heap. God is God who raises the poor. God can make a poor person. Remember, we know there's a poor man called in the gate of beat in Acts 3, whereby this man used to go to the gate to beg. He was a beggar and he was poor. But what happened? God raised him up. Those people were giving him money. When they saw him, the man is jumping, the man is praising God, they were surprised and shocked because God has raised him up and make him to rejoice. Be a beggar who was begging, who was being given a change, and people were walking to church. Nobody could help him even to drop him to the church. They left him there because he was begging there. But when he met the God of a miracle, who answered by fire through the servant of God, through Apostle Peter and John, the man received his power and started walking. God lift up. God answered the prayer of Peter and John through this man who rest up and start jumping and praising God. God will rest you up. No matter, even if you are poor right now, God will rest you up. Still there is time. God will rest you up. God will rest you up. God will bring wealthy. People will be surprised. When they look at you, they will not believe. Is this a man? Is this a woman who used to bowl us? Is this a woman who used to bowl money everywhere? He has money mat. He has every loans. You have bad credit. Nobody can follow you. Is this the one that now is lending? You will become the head. You will become the head, not the tail. You will never pour money to eat. This is the end. As this year is going to end, all debts get, you will never pull again in the mighty name of Jesus. You will be blessed. People will come and bless you. You will start seeing the blessings of God in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to speak to the heart. I'm going to speak to the heart to hear the word of God and release your blessings. Anything the heart has swallowed, they will vomit and bring it to you in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is a God of miracle. It is a God of miracle. I'm going to talk to the heart on behalf of you, and the heart will release your blessings before the end of the year, before the end of this month, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, God, oh heart, hear the word of the Lord. Swallow every enchanters assigned against this person. Let every enchanters to be swallowed. Let every witchcraft to be swallowed. Let every evil around you to be swallowed. Let the ground open and swallow anybody who is holding your blessings, anybody who is attacking you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the heart hear and open and swallow every enchanters, every witchcraft, every evil around you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the heart open and swallow them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, let the crystal pulse yes, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you. Let crystal pulse of enemy explode in their faces, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, I pray that God of Elijah, let the crystal pulse of the enemy explode in their faces, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let their crystal pulse explode in their faces, in the mighty name of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power calling your head before evil mirrors, die with the mirror. Any power calling your head, calling your name for before evil mirrors. You know there's wicked people. They go to the mirror, they start calling your name, they start calling your head, they start chanting against you. Let their mirror break. Let their mirror break on their face. Let that mirror break on their face, in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power, any witch, any evil, any visit, any voodoo, any witchcraft, calling your name, calling your head for evil with the evil mirrors, let that mirror break on their face. Let that mirror die, in the mighty name of Jesus. A lot of your father's house, I command them to go back to the Red Sea. There is a rod. A rod is the power that kills infants. A rod is the power that kills good things. A rod is the power that kills promotion. When you are promoted, a rod will rise up. A rod died many years, but it still is here. He will run for your promotion. He will run for the new job you are getting. He will run and start to destroy you. That is the power of a rod. Crying from your father's house, your mother's house, let them go to the Red Sea and die. Herod's power in your family, let them die. Herod is a great person, jealousy. When Herod spilled the sea, something good is coming, he will run for it and destroy it. Herod killed the children. He wanted to kill Jesus so that Jesus cannot be a prophet, cannot be a child of God. You know, Herod, he thought that Jesus would be a prophet, Jesus would be a child, Jesus would be the king of he would take over his ministry, he would take over his kingdom. That's why he said, this child, I'm going to kill this child so that he cannot achieve what has been prophesied. So when Herod look around and heard that the child is born, he makes sure that this child will not prosper. This child will not live. He will die so that he cannot fulfill his calling. That's why Herod went and killed all the children, thinking that he will kill Jesus. But God, who answered by fire, he came in a dream and tell his parents to leave and go to become a refugee in Egypt. Therefore, every Elode in your family, let them die. Every Elode following your miracle, let them die. Every Elode that is attacking you, let them die, in the mighty name of Jesus. Message of frustration. Carry your message back to your sender, in the mighty name of Jesus. Messenger of frustration, I command every messenger of frustration, every evil, that frustration is coming, let them call that message back to the sender. Anyone who is planning to frustrate you, anybody that they are ganging together to frustrate you, let everything they are planning turn back to the sender, turn back to them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray and I decree by the power in the blood of Jesus, let every messenger of affliction release your affliction back to the sender in the name of Jesus. Messenger of affliction, release your affliction on your sender in the name of Jesus. Messenger of sickness, let it release that sickness back to the sender. Messenger of poverty, let them release that poverty back to the sender in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of problem caused by enchantment, pick up your rod and go into the in the name of Jesus. Problem caused by witchcraft, problem caused by evil, by wicked, let them pick up their rod and go back and destroy themselves in Jesus' name. They are problem caused by evil, by wicked, by children of the wicked, the children of the wickedness. This, when they call their problem, they want to bring that problem to you. You have not done anything. They only look at you and they want to put that problem to you. Let them call their problem back to the sender. Let them that problem call their Lord back to them in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Infirmities, fall away. I command every infirmity to fall away from your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I curse every infirmity. I curse every sickness. I command sickness, diseases, evil cancer, evil HIV, all sickness and diseases in your body. I command them to fall down and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. I break the law of death over your life. You shall not die, but live to declare the word of God. I destroy and break every law of death. Any death that has been programmed in your life, I destroy them. I command it. You shall not die, but live to declare the words of God. I shall not die. You shall not die. Your children will not die. They will die on their age when they finish 120 years. No one will die premature in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy sentences of death in the mighty name of Jesus. No sickness, no accident, no evil will kill you in the mighty name of Jesus. I break and destroy every concentration of sorcerers against you. I command them to be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. I scatter consultation. People who are going to consult the witchcraft, consult the sorcerers, consult the Satan to kill you, to destroy your children, to destroy your business. Let them be destroyed. Let them be destroyed. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Every problem harboring enchantment against you, I command them to die by fire. Die by fire. Die by fire. Every problem harboring enchantment, every problem calling, every problem giving witchcraft power against your life, let them die. Let them die by fire. Let them die by fire. Let them catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Father. I am going to talk to the sun, the moon, and the star to form it every enchantment against you, to form it every witchcraft programmed in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, you sun, moon, and star, hear the word of God. Form it every witchcraft, form it every enchanters which has been assigned against these people, which have been assigned against you. You know, they can program witchcraft in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars. And they will speak to the star. The star, the sun, the moon will carry witchcraft against you. Therefore, I command them to come against, I destroy them. I command them to die. Let them to die where they are holding them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Enchanters will not settle down in your life in Jesus' name. Witchcraft will not settle in your life in Jesus' name. Witchcraft will not settle in your life in Jesus' name. Every magic pole on the ground to subdue your life, I command them to backfire. I command them to go back to the sender. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Every power that weakens your spiritual authority, I command them to die. Any power that is weakening your prayers, any power that is attacking your prayer and fasting, any power that is attacking your prayers, let them die by fire. Let them die by fire. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Mass clothed, assigned to sleep in your house, die, die, die. There is powers called vampire, mass clothed, that the enemy assigned, they come and sleep in your house. That's why You have these bad dreams. That's why you have terrible dreams. Because masquerade is sleeping in your house. Because vampire is in your house. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes. Let them catch, burn, and every demon living in your house, bringing these evil dreams, attacking you, let them be vanished. Let them be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord, my Father. I pray, I am asking the Son, oh, Son, arise, smite everything. A sign against your life, a sign against your children, a sign against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the Son arise and smite everything that is a sign against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, I want to thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God, we thank you. Lord, we bless your name. I bless you, God. I thank you, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, whatsoever you have not planted in the life of these people, uprooted them, uprooted them, uprooted them, uprooted them, uprooted them, uprooted them by fire, uprooted them by fire. Anything you have not planted in the life of these people, anything that the Father has not planted in you, let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. Be uprooted. Be uprooted. Be uprooted. Be uprooted in the name of Jesus. Anything that the Father has not planted in your life, anything that your Father has not planted in your life, let it be uprooted, be uprooted, be uprooted, be uprooted, be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus. Then dead bones of your life arise up from the dead in Jesus' name. Anything dead in your life, let it arise, 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 arise by fire, arise by fire, arise by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your star manifest by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your star manifest by fire. Let your star manifest by fire. Let your star shine by fire. Let your star shine, shine by fire in the name of Jesus. Your star sign, let your star sign by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Anyone that your star has been attacked, anyone here, the star has been damaged, let it be signed, let it be signed, let it be signed again and again in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Let your star manifest by fire. Let your star manifest by fire in the name of Jesus. Power of God, arise. Produce your way unto your breakthroughs in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the power of God arise and produce your way unto the breakthroughs in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Lord. I call upon the producer of power for your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Producer power of your breakthrough appear in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I declare and command every evil spiritual umbrella cord, biblical cord, through which portioning flow into your destiny, I command them to catch fire, to catch fire in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name in the mighty name of Jesus. Satanic umbrella covering your prayer, die, destroyed. Let the wind flow them and destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every spiritual biblical cord through which is portion flying unto your destiny, I command them to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Every prayer mat assigned against you, I command them to die. They are wicked people. They are satanic priests, satanic prophets, wicked people. They will sit on the mat and start speaking against you and speak hours, chanting and evil and speaking hours and hours against you until they see something has happened. Let that mat catch fire. Let them be wasted. Let them, those prayers, die. All the prayers that are offering, let them die, die, die in the name of Jesus. Any power assigned to terminate your purpose on earth, I command them to die in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Every power that wants you to die unused, I command them to die. Any power that wants you to die unused, any power that does not want you to live, let them die by fire. Let them die by fire. Let them die by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you. Every power that wants you to die unaccomplished, this power wants you to die useless. This power wants you to die without anything. They have said you will die without nothing. Let those power die in the mighty name of Jesus. This is spiritual warfare. This is spiritual warfare. I destroy them. I render them powerless. Let them be rendered powerless. Let them be crushed into the fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Strange voices holding you down. Let them go away. Let them go away. Let them go away. Let them go away in the mighty name of Jesus. Any strange voices holding you down. Let them die. Let them die. Let them die. Let them die. Die in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. I want to thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Let God open doors of opportunity to you through this prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God, let God open opportunities. Let God open doors for you in this prayer in Jesus' name. I command all evil and unknown forces organized against you, against your life, to be scattered in the name of Jesus. I paralyze every activities of physical and spiritual parasite and devours in your life in the name of Jesus. Powers denying you your due miracle, receive the stone of fire. Receive the stone of fire in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I want to thank you. Lord, I bless you. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to thank you very much. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you so much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Sig, saying bye-bye. Bye-bye. See you tonight, 9 p.m. Babcon. To see you 9 p.m. Popcorn and prayer line. Remember to call me for raising up your altar. Our number is 905-792-3798. Call me. I am here to pray with you. Our email address is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Call me. Email me. Our website is www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Go there and God will help you in Jesus' name. Also, we have videos. We have YouTube. Go to our YouTube and like our videos. Light Overcomers DHM Ministries. Light Overcomers D Dog H House Ministries. Right there, all the videos will come. Go there and like them. Or if you can go to our website, you will see on the top of the website, Google Plus, YouTube, Facebook, you will see all the medias we have. Go there and help yourself. It is treasure. It is .com. www.overcomersdhministriesblogspot.ca.com is email. .ca is website. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you once again. I love you so much. I love you. There's nothing I can do about it. Call me. I want to help you to raise up the altar that will speak to you. That will speak a miracle to you. You need a miracle. God of a miracle is here. He will deliver you. He will give you a miracle that you are looking for. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time, people of God. See you tonight, 9 p.m. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye.